Hey guys, John V from PhoneArena here. You're watching our video comparison between the Samsung Galaxy S6 and the Apple iPhone 6. Apple's bread and butter is no doubt the iPhone 6. It's quite a formidable piece of hardware, and that's despite being several months old at this point. It's still quite relevant. Meanwhile though, Samsung has something very intriguing up its sleeve with its Samsung Galaxy S6 smartphone. It's its newest flagship smartphone. Not only it's a features-rich handset, but it's also packing several new changes as well. We'll see how it's going to fare against the iPhone 6. In the past, Apple's designs were always superior to anything that Samsung has produced, but with the introduction of the S6, that's all changing. It brings it to the same level that we see in the iPhone 6. Now, it's really tough to say which design would prefer more just because they both have their outstanding qualities. With the S6, it now has a more premium aesthetic thanks to its choice of materials. You have a glass front, glass back, sandwiched together with the metal trim bezel, and it just has a very nice compact feel for a handset with a pretty large display. And we really like how the back casing has a dazzling effect as light bounces off it. But over with the iPhone 6, what's really great is that we find it's a little bit more solid and durable. That's because of its aluminum body. So if we were to drop this, it would definitely handle a lot better than the glass surfaces of the S6. On top of that, the iPhone 6 is the more compact handset, so it's easier to grasp with one hand. They have also fingerprint sensors incorporated into their home buttons. Same execution, so they're pretty effortless and they work pretty well. But you get a wider selection of features with the S6. For example, you have an IR blaster, which makes it double as a universal remote. And then you have also the heart rate sensor in the back, so you can measure your pulse if you wanted to. The displays are sharp and brilliant with the two. The main advantage with the S6 is that it's larger, higher resolution, and it's also more color accurate than the iPhone 6. It's a 5.1-inch Quad HD Super AMOLED display versus the smaller 4.7-inch Retina display of the iPhone 6. Now, the iPhone 6 utilizes IPS LCD technology, and what really stands tall is in the brightness output. It's brighter outdoors, but the S6 is still pretty potent, so we didn't have any issues viewing both. But like I said, when it comes to details, the S6's Quad HD resolution makes a lot of difference. You won't notice it when you're looking at it from a normal distance. Actually, it'd be tough to gauge that. But when you look at it very close, especially in the web browser, when you're looking at something, an overview of a website, we do notice there's more detail with the S6. Now, the core experiences, it's of course that battle between iOS versus Android. In this case, Samsung's interpretation, which is TouchWiz. Now, iOS 8 has always been great in the fact that it is just simple, straightforward, and easy to operate. There's no bells and whistles with the feature set, but the ones that does offer are very meaningful, and a lot of people will appreciate the simplicity of iOS 8, and that's what the main attraction to it is. Whereas with the S6, in the past, TouchWiz has always been all about the features, and sometimes it came off as overwhelming. Samsung has toned it down here with its latest version of TouchWiz running on top of Android 5.0 Lollipop, and you do notice it from the visuals and into the feature set. So in the visual department, it has a higher degree of customization than iOS 8, but that's Android in general. And on top of that, you still have some very useful features like multi-windows for true multitasking, and you have a one-handed mode for easier interaction with the platform. So as far as power users are concerned, they might be attracted more to the TouchWiz experience, but you still can't go wrong with iOS 8. The two are pretty fast with their performances. The S6 is powered by Samsung's very own octa-core 64-bit base Exynos chip, the latest generation. And the iPhone 6 is powered by Apple's own dual-core 64-bit base A8 chip. And honestly, on the surface, it's almost tough to say which one is the better performer. Both are exceptionally responsive with a variety of different tasks. But the iPhone 6 seems to have a slight advantage when it comes to gaming. It's less prone to slower frame rates. Now that's partly attributed to the S6's higher resolution display, so there's a little more taxing when it comes to processing that. But you know, at the end of the day, both are pretty much on par to one another. Now in the back, they both have, actually the S6 has a larger 16 megapixel autofocus camera, whereas with the iPhone 6, it has a smaller 8 megapixel camera. Now, when it comes to quality, honestly, the iPhone 6 has always been a standout device in that category, and you definitely see it with its outdoor shots. It just produces slightly livelier looking photos, despite the fact that it's not quite as detailed compared to what you get with the S6. And that's the advantage of having 16 megapixels. It's just able to grasp a lot more detail than its rival. In the low lighting department, the two are exceptional as well. At times, it's the S6 producing the better shots, and the other, it's the iPhone 6. So it's tough to say which one's better in that. When it comes to video recording, however, we do like the S6 a little bit more, just because you get the advantage of shooting video in 4K. So with 4K, you're gonna get a lot more detail than you would 1080p. Though to compare apples to apples, 1080p quality, you won't be disappointed by either device. When we're using it for phone calls, we're not really won over by one more so than the other, and we actually find their qualities to be rather average. Not really one that's reeling us in. It gets the job done, but nothing incredible to tell you the truth. Now, as far as battery life though, it's the S6, the S6 producing the longer battery life. Now, in our battery benchmark test, it produces a mark of 7 hours and 14 minutes, which is far exceeds the 5 hour and 22 minute mark of the iPhone 6. So purely in terms of longevity, you can get a little bit more juice out of the S6. There's a reason why the iPhone 6 is the best-selling smartphone out there. It just works, and it's a great all-around smartphone, despite being not really big on the specs, but more about the experience. Meanwhile, with the Galaxy S6, Samsung has something very intriguing going on. We applaud them for the new design language, but more importantly, it also runs on all cylinders by performing handily in a bunch of different categories on par to the iPhone 6, if not better. Now, if you're gonna pick up either handset, they're similarly priced with the base models, though you only get 16 gigabytes of memory with the iPhone 6 versus 32 gigabytes with the S6. Either way, you can't go wrong with either device. So if you guys wanna learn more about both handsets, you can check out our website, phonearena.com. It's John V. Thanks for watching.